So, in today's video, we're looking at how you can use Notion to create photo galleries as well as upload receipts. We'll be demonstrating these two examples in today's video, so let's jump in. So we're going to be demonstrating this one on iOS today, so hopefully this one explains it. It's pretty similar on Android, so if you have any questions, pop them in the comments below. I'm sure we'll happily help. Just so you guys know, there's a brand new Notion course, which we fully released now. You can find it in the description below and get $50 off the full price if you are a Patreon subscriber. So do check it out below. There's 24 lessons, 25 bonus lessons, and tons more content updated monthly. So let's move on to these photo galleries. So to start out, it's worth grabbing your iPhone or Android device. Now you need to have this share extension enabled, and this is really easy to do. And all you need to do here is go to your Photos app, select the photos you want in the gallery in Notion, and go ahead and press the share button in the bottom left-hand corner. Now you need to be able to toggle Notion on and drag it to a more sensible location. Now once you're happy and you've got maybe two or three photos you want to share, then go ahead and press the Notion button. Now you have a prompt with a couple of options there. Of course, you have the ability to add it to an existing photo gallery. In this case, we're going to create a brand new links database. Once you press save, of course, you need to title it with what information is there. So in this case, the BOS conference. And if I press save, it will go into my Notion workspace, but it will sit just outside of it. Now, naturally, like all new links databases that are created, you have to move them back in and actually title them something different. But as you can see here, it's created a gallery database and a list database view that will allow you to see all of your photos. Now, once you open the card, of course, you can see all of the photos. You can add just one or many. And we actually did this one for the San Francisco photos I had. And it's a great way to be able to store photos. And of course, you can go over to Properties and press Page Content. This will allow you to see the page content when you're in that gallery database view. Now, this is really neat because I found a lot of people will start to use this to save photos. And the great thing is, if you're not on the free plan, there's no limit to how many photos you can add. There's no upload limit. But if you are on the free plan, you can upload up to 5 megabytes per file. And naturally, each image will be referenced as one block. So the great news is you can start uploading your photos. You can also do this with receipts as well. I think this could be a good way for people to capture receipts that they take. For example, I have a few receipts here from San Francisco from places we visited, taxis. So I'm just going to press all of these, send them over using the share extension. And as you can see, they've imported here. Now, the great thing is, as I mentioned, you can add all of the regular property types you would. So, for example, if you want to tag these as business trip or leisure trip, you can do. And of course, you can be able to add all the details there. So like normal, you could probably save these if you wanted to upload them to your own service, but you then have a good backlog of them now. But do remember that only if you've got them offline will they show. If you do not have the page saved offline, and that's just by simply viewing the cache version of it, you won't be able to view these. So make sure that you have that and note that obviously the offline experience isn't as good as necessarily online experiences. But of course, they're looking to improve this as stated in the What's New area. So guys, hopefully this is a nice overview of how you can use Notion's gallery ability to create little photo galleries of your trips and even the ability to start tagging some receipts. Now, you can add some real additions to these. So for example, the photo galleries, you could start adding captions, you could start adding little stories, you know, start sharing them with other people who were there. And it could be a good way in being able to share stuff. And with the receipts, of course, you can use the export to PDF function if you wanted to actually export that receipt into a PDF to then upload to your own receipt bank or whatever you use. For example, it could be Expensify, etc. So it's quite a neat way, and I would recommend checking this one out, see whether it's suitable for you. Let me know if you've got any questions in the comments, and I will happily answer them. And do make sure to check out the Notion Made Simple course if you're a total newbie, or you know someone that would like to benefit from a beginner course. And of course, it goes up to advanced as well, so you do have real depth and real knowledge that you can learn. Anyway, guys, a huge thank you for stopping by today. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you guys very soon. If you're brand new here, do subscribe. It'd be great to have you. Anyway, guys, Thanks so much, and I'll talk to you soon. Cheers.